Hello guys and welcome to my channel. Today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be making a Lego lightsaber and Lego character, importing it into Blender, rendering one image and making the lightsaber look cool in compositing. So the first thing you want to do is go to mechabricks.com, make an account, it's free, and then after you've made an account, go to workshop, and we're just going to create a character. So the fast way is you can look up what you want, so I'm going to go for clone. I'm going to add some pants, some legs here. You can go to this bar, it's not going to pop up for the video, but you can press on this bar and scroll all the way down and you will find minifigure lower parts and upper parts and heads and all that. But this is the fast way. So clone, and then I'm just going to add this one. Yep, and then I'm going to add a head as well. So I'm going to add some accessories, which is like a hood. Yeah, hood for cloak. Going to turn that to black. Yep, black. And I'm going to add a cape. No. Cape. Here we go. And you can change that to whatever color you want. So after you've done that, you will now want to make a lightsaber. So lightsaber, look that up in the search bar. And before you click on that, you want to select this middle dot of the hand and select the light sword shaft. So do on your keyboard, if you have one, do two page ups, or two up arrow keys, two right arrow keys, and two down arrow keys. And once you've done that, you want to go to the snapping grid over here and change it to small, so it's smooth. Right? So now you have your lightsaber, you want to add a rod. And that's the last thing we need to do. So click on this one, the lightsaber blade. Do two right keys, two up keys, two right keys, and then drag that up here. I'm just going to set that to purple. It actually doesn't matter what color you're using for the light saber, because we're going to change that in Blender. So once you've done that, make sure you have an account. You're going to go to file, save as, rename your character, and then save that. And then once it's saved, you want to go file, export, format, change it from Collider to Blender add-on, right? Then click export. Okay, so now that you've downloaded your character, you want to go to file, import. If you don't have Mechabricks add-on import thing, go to my first tutorial and look up how to install all the rig add-ons and the import Mechabricks file format. So once you've done that, click Mechabricks, set MBX, go to your downloads and look for your character. And I'm going to click on this one that I made, and this is my Mace Windu. Go to render. Don't use Eevee. It sucks. Denosing and click yes please. And that's what it should look like. I'm just going to add a floor first. So shift A. So go to press N. I'm just gonna okay, so we have this here, we have a character here, and we're gonna rig him now. So first thing you wanna do is select a leg, pelvis, torso, arms, and kind of like a chain. Go back, do not select the cape, but only select the body parts. So as you can see, I've selected the minifigure, none of the lightsaber, the hood, or the cape, or whatever. And now you want to press N, go to Epic Fig Rig. Again, if you don't have the Epic Fig Rig, go to my other tutorial on how to install all that stuff. Rig selected minifigure, and you should have your rigged minifigure. Now, what you want to do is, you want to parent all these accessories to your minifigure. So, select the blade, the pebble blade. Shift select the lightsaber. Control P. Object keeps transform. That keeps the object in, like, together and in the same place, like when you're moving around the minifigure. Alright. And now you want to select the lightsaber handle. Select the hand. Control P. Object keep transform. Alright. Now what you want to do is select the cape, select the torso, control P, keep object keep transform. And just do the same for all your accessories. So I selected the hood and then the head. Alright. Now what we can do is, we can go to pose mode, select the rig, and go to pose mode, or you can go control tab. Alright, and now if we move the torso, there's another set of arms and legs here, I don't know why that's there. Alrighty, so I'm also going to make this floor a bit bigger. So press S and scale that all the way up, like that. Select the rig again, control tab, and if you have your minifigure and he's in a place that you don't want him to be, you can select the part of the rig that you moved, and you can go Alt-R or Alt-G. I'm going to select the torso now, and Alt-R. Right? Alt-G, Alt-R. I don't know why that's not working. Yep, so we have our minifigure. So we have our minifigure, and he's rigged. And I just scaled the floor up a bit, so that he's standing on something. And now what you want to do is pose him. So I'm just going to have him with his arm up like that. And so this one moves the arm in a straight line, vertically. And then this one, you can move it on the Z-axis. Okay, so now that I've rigged and posed my minifigure, all you want to do now is select Control Tab, go back to Object Mode, and select the saber. We're going to add a new material, so it's going to have this material. Make your bricks, blah blah blah. So you just want to press this minus key. So now it doesn't have a color. Alright, and so you want to add new. And you want to go to, I'm going to name this purple saber. Alright, leave that as principled BSDF. Turn the roughness all the way down. Leave that, transmission 100%. And clear coat, emission, all the way up. I'm just going to go for a blue color. I forgot to change this base color to a dark purple. Like a purpley color, like that. Now it'll look blue. I'm going to change the emission strength to 32.44. Oh, wait, I think it was 33.4. There we go. Now we kind of have like a purple lightsaber. You can change the color if you want, but I messed around with it before, and that's what I got. So now if we go to render view, we have a glowing lightsaber in cycles. So make sure this is in cycles. Yes. So That's all you basically have to do. You can select denoising and go to render, denoising, render, and select denoising. Usually the tiles when you're rendering are like this big, but I'm just gonna make them like this big. So go to performance. This is if you want your tiles to be that big. I'm gonna go 100. Save it, file, save, and then click render. Render that image, and once it's done, alright, so click render image. Oh, sorry, we actually forgot to add a camera, so shift A, add a camera, and if you select this button here and go to view, you can select camera to view, and when you scroll out, you can change the position. I'm just going to go like that. You can go to render view to see what it looks like. I can go like that. Alright, and once you have your camera done, you can exit out of camera to view by disabling that. And I'm going to add a wall behind it so it doesn't look like he's standing in the middle of nowhere. So if you press R then X, rotate on the X axis, you can press 90 degrees by just entering 90. And then move it back. That, and then you have a background. So now that you have your character posed, and you have a camera, and the render properties are set, and you have your glowing material on your lightsaber, this is not what it's going to look like after you composite, right? So now what you want to do is click render, then render image. Alright, so now what you want to do is change this to solid view so your computer isn't burning up. Go to compositing and click use nodes. Now you'll see this here, and what you want to do is you want to go here, drag that over there, and off here, you know, shift A, look up denoise, hook image up to image. And go over here and look up viewer so you can see everything that's happening. Image up to image. And if you press V, you can zoom out, Alt V to zoom in. So that's that. And now you can see it looks alright, but you can see the lightsaber sucks. So what we want to do is we want to look up shift A, hue, correct, put that in there, and put these, that, or the other way around. Quite sure. Like that, but you also want to give it some glow. So shift A, glare, put that in there. Change this to fog glow. As you can see, it's already looking better. Medium, threshold 0. Size 7, and just play around with this. And now if you go to UV editing, and you press this one, and scroll all the way down to viewer node, you can see your character and all the compositing stuff. And if you want to save that, you go to image, save, and find your place with all your renders and save. I forgot to name it. But yes, so that is how you composite a lightsaber. Make it look like that. So yeah, thank you for watching and please subscribe.